Are we living in the last days? Is Jesus returning soon? Are there signs pointing to this happening right now? I've seen you guys asking this question a lot, and I have seen video after video of people showing all the signs that Jesus is about to return. We've got wars going on. That's a sign. We've got earthquake, disease, famine. Those are signs. But let me ask you a question. Hasn't that stuff been going on for like ever? You see, I don't want to break anybody's heart today, but everybody's looking at the wrong signs. Do I think Jesus is coming back soon? Oh, absolutely I do. But most people are looking for the wrong signs. You see, Jesus told us exactly what's going to happen in the last days. I mean, in Matthew 24, he does say there's going to be wars and signs of wars. But then he says, don't panic. These things must happen, but the end won't follow immediately. But pay attention, because then he goes on to tell us exactly what we need to be looking for, what we need to be prepared for, what most people seem to be missing. You see, in verses 11 and 12, he says, and many false prophets will appear and deceive many. Sin will be rampant everywhere, and the love of many will grow cold. That's the sign we should be looking for. Yeah, we got wars, famines, all that stuff, but that was just the birth pains. You see, the true sign, the big aha moment, letting us know that Jesus is about to return, is when the hearts of Christians have grown cold. When you see people who believe in God, who claim Jesus to be their Lord, constantly fighting with one another, arguing over stupid issues like Halloween, and if tattoos are a sin or not, all while missing the greater calling of loving each other and sharing and spreading the gospel as far as they can. Yeah, that sounds like today. You see, the Bible tells us in the end, many false prophets will come. The problem with that is you're looking in the pulpit. But the truth is, there's way more false prophets in the pews than there are in the pulpit. You see, the love of many will grow cold. And the reason for that is Christians are so easily offended. You see, you have to understand, offense is the bait of Satan. Satan wants to put you in a trap, all he's got to do is get you offended. I mean, the word offense comes from the word scandalon, which means the bait stick of a trap. You see, what Jesus was telling us is in the end days, people are going to be so offended over tiny, stupid, ridiculous things that do not even matter that they miss the entire point of what they've been called to do. And when they fall into that trap of offense and they hold on to bitterness, resentment, and unforgiveness, their hearts start to grow cold. You see, that's why our Bible says it's he who endures to the end will be saved. Yeah, Kelly, but that scripture's talking about, you know, the world sinners, you know, they got to endure to the end if they want to get saved. Oh, really? How can you endure to the end of a race if you've never started the race? That scripture's talking about Christians. You see, I know Jesus is coming back soon because I see more hate than love. I see more bitterness and unforgiveness than repentance and forgiveness. It's very obvious that the hearts of many are growing cold. But let me encourage you today. This shouldn't bring you any fear. Remember what Matthew 5:14 tells us. We are the light of the world. And where does light do the best work? In the darkness. Don't live offended today. Our Bible tells us not to be easily offended so that you stay out of that trap. As a body of believers, we should be unified with one goal, to tell as many people as we can about the love and grace and salvation of Jesus Christ. Oh, they believe in Halloween and you don't? So what? Does it change salvation? Not at all. Yeah, but they listen to Metallica and I listen to Elevation. So what? Does it change salvation at all? Listen, every single person is going to live up to or down to the revelation that they have of the freedom that Jesus bought and paid for them. If they are convicted by something and you're not, so what? You have your walk and they have theirs. But our ultimate goal should be the same. We may not agree on all the little details, but we should all agree that the world needs Jesus now more than ever. It's time for the church to be the church. Let's endure to the end. Jesus is coming soon. But that doesn't mean sit at the bus stop and wait for your ride home. Because when the boss shows up, I want him to find me working. And think about that for a minute. Hey, if this message blessed you today, please check out my brand new book. It just came out. It's a 40-day devotional called Think About That for a Minute, Volume 2. Every single day, we take a scripture, we break it down, apply it to our life. There's a prayer for the day and then space for you to write down what God is speaking to you. Look, this is an excellent tool and resource to come alongside your Bible reading. It shouldn't take place of it. And for those who even want to go deeper, there is an official study guide you can get that goes with it. It gives you 8 to 10 questions every day that just helps you go deep and pull out as much understanding from the text that you can and apply it to your life. Amen. Look, these books have blessed so many people. They bless me. I know it's going to bless you. You can get it today at kellykministries.com. Or if you want it cheaper, faster, free shipping, go grab it on Amazon. Either way, get it today. And you know, think about that for a minute.